Okay, just a quick one. I got carried away. I did a video before, but I think I don't want to go to prison. So I was a little bit carried away with Venezuela, you know. I must say, my respect to these people, you know. When was it New York, which was out for maybe a day or an hour and a half without power, and there was raping, looting, killing, violence. What the heck was going on there, right? So now you see Venezuela with days and weeks without power. None of this happens. They just help each other. And that's the way humans are to be, right? We are to help each other. Not, you know, where do I put my thingy next? You know, in, oh, I could throw up. So, back to Fedora. So, Fedora 29, it is what it is. It is a testing platform. And I would think maybe after 6, 7 months it might be stable. And then for another 5 months you have fun. And then the next version comes out. So, for people who like tinkering or playing around, it might be okay. For me, yeah, as long as I play this World of Tank game, which is most likely not too long anymore, but I don't know what it does with other games. Like when, if I don't get sound in the wine game from World of Tanks, I most likely don't get sound from a game, from another game, right? I do get sound from wine, I just don't get sound when this play game plays, and it does not show up in Pulse Audio like it does everywhere else. So that's what happening is happening on Fedora, but no, not criticizing too much. Everybody knows it's a testing version. I would call it beta, because if you compare their testing to Debian testing is super stable. You can use it as a rolling release. The chances to get a bad surprise are very, very little. The chance to get a very good surprise on Fedora is very little. No, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I lose subscribers like other people here, right? However, sorry guys, got carried away. So my best experience so far, I think I screwed something up with my VirtualBox here on Calculate Linux, but not bad enough that I would install it again. I just run another installation here. You can see the spelling error. Windows 7 Pro, I did that. I do my work with it, works fine. My printer scanner works all right. Gscan works perfect. VirtualBox works nice. My game runs. Nvidia graphic card is installed. Redshift works fine. Got Google Chromium, I mean Chromium, Google Chrome, Thunderbird, VirtualBox. So and I mean printing, scanning. This is what I need for work or for my digital life. How do you say that nowadays? Otherwise, Calculate is like I remember it: snappy, fast, stable. Doing pretty good. I think I can remove this one because what I did some changes. What I got to do is I can go from my Synology drive and here, and I use this app folder now. So I use Control, Alt, and Shift, and I get the link symbol, and then I let go, and now I've got my apps here. Duran. So the downside I have with Calculate Linux is, if you look, have a look here. So the Synology drive should be running. Oh, I don't see it. Okay, so most likely I just use F3 and I write Synology. And there it is. The Synology drive is running. You see that? So that's doing okay. Well, what it doesn't do is notes. Notes doesn't work anymore. So, and I believe I saw that on Magia. Notes is relying on an older lib something. It's the same crap like rubbish, like Viber has. You know, they made that package. I don't know, 1847. I never changed it. And I mean, shame on you, Synology. You are actually somebody who wants to make network attack storages for working environments, and working environments do use RPMs, and they're not always super old, like CentOS or something like that. And other things, I mean, yes, Ubuntu is used a lot, Debian is okay, and but it would be okay to update your packages once in a while and Yeah, keep your hands on the development. I mean, all you got to do is, as much as I know, don't make it specific on the lip number. Make it specific on the lip, because usually they're backwards compatible. So there shouldn't be any problem to do that. So Synology, listen up to your users. Nevertheless, does it stop me? No. Because I can still go and if I really need my notes, usually I've got them on all my handheld devices. And if I want to do it on my computer, I just log into my Synology station, open it up there and can do whatever I want. So if does Gregor by chance can see that video, and if he watches this, he usually watches to the end. So what I try to do on Synology is I get CalDAV running. I do get CalDAV activated, running on my cell phone if I use the IP address, but it just doesn't show. It was supposed to be showing up at the calendar as a guest entry or something, but it just doesn't. It doesn't show up. Nope, does not. However, long story short, so contacts I didn't even try yet. But I don't get access from outside, and you can use Synology.me and whatever you use for your network as storage device name. I use that before the dot Synology.me, and then you use your logging 5001 as the port for HTTPS, and that should work. If somebody has that working, let me know. I am too stupid. I cannot work it. Oh, talking about stupid, I'm actually really intelligent and have evidence. Yeah, you would say, oh, you just say so. No, I really have evidence. I bought a puzzle, and it said on the package 5 years. So I worked every day 5 hours on it, and in 2 weeks I finished it. Yeah. So that is 14 times 5. That is 70 hours instead of 5 years. So if I'm not smart, then I have no clue what smart is anymore. Right? I should become president, I think. Yeah, from something. I'll be my own president here in this horror house I'm living. However, this is it. So I'm really super intelligent. So all you bow down, show me some respect. I do in 70 hours what supposes to be done in 5 years. Man, that makes me feel good, right? So, having said this, nothing really happens in the computer world in a moment. MX is behaving. I encountered the struggle with VirtualBox. I think it's a VirtualBox update, you know, to 6. When you open it up in 6, I think it gets updated, and then you can't get it open up anymore in lower than 6 or whatsoever. I don't know what, I haven't figured it out yet. I tried what Sergi showed me from Acro Linux, Dubois. He had made a video about what he's doing with VirtualBox. I don't know. I don't know if it works with me. I just did new ones. It's a quick thing. And what I usually do, once I build them and install my apps, then I make a tar file of it, an archive, and then I just save them, and if I need them again, I fire them back up. And let's hope I can always open at least one, because I've got 5 or 6. When I pack them, they're just 4.9 gigabytes, so that's okay, right? Who cares? It's still okay. So, this is it. That's a very short video. If you like tinkering, Fedora. If you want to use something like Fedora, but in stable, that is CentOS, and I think in 2020, CentOS 8 is coming out. And their long-term support is 150 years, so you can, once you use it, you can keep using it, and usually that is super stable. So you will have something like Firefox number 12, Thunderbird number 11, and... yeah, Redshift is not out then. No, it is out. I'm joking. No, honestly, I can't wait to see CentOS coming out, and then I would like to play around with that. And if they use KDE, 100% they're using a KDE version which is not full of flaws. So that would be interesting to see which version that is and how does it run. Do I use KDE? I used it when the first LTS versions came out, and it was great because LTS meant stable at this time. And then they screwed it up because LTS was nothing else anymore than a testing bed. Then KDE just got kicked off my desktop. That was it. Back to XFCE. Because I need something reliable. I cannot have that. You get new options, works great, wonderful. Then you get an update, all these things you just get used to it are not working anymore. They all have glitches. So rubbish, not good. Then I rather stick with what I got, and I know how it works, and I know that it works all the time. Yeah, at all times. All the time, at all times. So especially if you have a rolling release, like Calculate Linux, I think XFCE is the way to go. You shouldn't get any surprises. If you have GNOME, that means you have a computer which gives you zero information, which can do very little. You just have to hope a lot that things work out, because you have almost no means to check anything. Their file manager is it's not even a file manager. I'm surprised it can even show some files. Yeah, it's a joke. It's a joke. However, I said this is a short video, so I cut it off here. I got to cut it off. Got work to do, but not yet. In 1.5 hour, I'm working again. So, yeah, I hope you find that video a little bit informative. I mean, Venezuela, my respect. Your people are very civilized. They're very social. They're doing what humans are supposed to do. So, really, my respect to that country and their people. What happens to them, totally unfair. Those people who are doing it, things they go away. No, you know, there is a God and he's coming. Yoo-hoo! So that's a good thing, right? So I can't wait. I mean, I cannot wait for my God to show up. Oh, that's great. Great news to me. However, yeah, what can I say? I just played here a little bit on Calculate Linux. I can't see a performance difference. I altered the volume, I made it a bit higher. So I couldn't see any performance difference between playing on MX-18 or playing on Calculate Linux. I think both are very stable, snappy, super snappy distros. They are based on different base distros or Linux versions, let's say. So they are very nice to use two of them on one upper computer, because if something gets broken somewhere, you can use the other one to do your important work and then fix it, the other one, when you got time. And you even get access through it. So, having said all that, I'm very, very impressed. I saw people tested already SolidXK. I was on that for a while too, liked it. But in a moment, I'm looking for Magia 7. I really want to see it finished. And hopefully it does well. Then, the next one I'm waiting for, and that I'm really waiting for that, that's CentOS. And that's because with CentOS, I have very, very good server experience. Really good server experience. So, and I do believe it's a rock solid operating system. Because as I said, it's not bleeding edge and stuff like that. And I can't wait to see it. But also Magia 7, I really want to see that coming out as stable and working. In a moment, soon I hope I have a little bit more time. And then I try to go on a forum and see if they can help me to get World of Tanks installed. But in a 64-bit version. So, isn't there Luntris? That should install that too, right? So I have to have a look, you know. There's lots of things to discover. I'm a little bit behind with the gaming platform or catalogs and software catalogs and stuff like that. So that would be interesting to see, right? But for me, gaming is fifth important. First is browsing the internet, email client, scanning, printing, VirtualBox. Yeah, and then maybe comes gaming. So, and of course I need music, video and stuff like that. So, yeah. All right, guys, this is it. I love my new computer. My wife hates it. She thought it cost $2,000. Man, I wish. That's a cheap one, but it's one. It works. So, back to the story. I love it. It's an i5-8400. It has only 8 gigabyte RAM. And an NVIDIA graphic card, the GTX 1050i. And it does okay now. I mean, MX 17.1 installs the NVIDIA graphic card driver just fine. 18 did not. Calculate Linux, of course, no trouble. Magia 7, of course, no trouble. Oh, I haven't tried if 6 runs here. See, I tried 7, but I never tried 6. Because now I have a different computer. It's not the Optimus laptop anymore. The Optimus laptop is now for quick work upstairs where the HP Pavilion laptop was. So it makes such a difference. Now it can at least work a little bit. And Yeah. A little advice. If you go for a working computer for work, don't go for that cheap rubbish. Go for a cheap gaming computer. That means you have enough computing power so that your computer is not old after 6 months. So you can still work with it. You don't have to wait forever. It's doing a good job. So don't go for the cheap stuff. That is just, I don't have money for cheap things, because when you buy cheap, you have to buy twice or three times. So buy first properly. Yeah, I have to make another few videos about those subjects, I think. Because it's important to know. You waste your money if you buy cheap, and that's so annoying. But this is it, guys. Short, informative video. I hope that was helpful, useful for somebody. And if not, maybe a little bit entertaining. And otherwise, this is it. This is DZ Me Linux, your host. Don't forget Patreon, money, money, money. Oh, I forgot. Yes, currency is crashing again. Economy is crashing again. The end of the world is near, and blah, 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 blah. Every week is so is the economy crashing, and so this is it. Buy gold, it's always good, and it keeps you going. When you're hungry, you just suck it. Gold bearer. Okay, you got all my good advice here, so don't forget to send all the money. Have a good day, guys. Bye, bye, bye.